What are the first images, a scene, a character, a dialogue of a fantasy novel or a short story that struck you as a boy, making you feel for the first time that there was something fascinating you in that way of telling?
Yeah, I have a pretty terrible memory from my childhood, so I'm not sure there's one event that really stands out. Just feels like fantasy has always been there for me. I mean, Tolkien certainly was the first stepping stone, I think. From The Hobbit, I very distinctly remember Bilbo meeting Smaug for the first time and their trading of cunning in the darkness. I very much remember Lord of the Rings and the descent into Moria. And Wizard of Earthsea, Ursula Le Guin, is a real milestone and important thing for me as well. I remember the warriors coming out of the mist being a really influential thing for me. But very quickly, I started playing a lot of role-playing games and a lot of Dungeons and Dragons and things of that kind. And drawing a lot of maps, a lot of dungeons, making up a lot of characters and a lot of places and settings. And so I think for me, fantasy's always been as much about the act of creation, in a way, as it is about the act of kind of passively absorbing other authors' worlds. So maybe that's why when it came to writing myself, fantasy was always the thing I thought of doing, because to me, fantasy had always been about creating my own stories.
As Pat Rothfuss said, it is often just as important to understand what we don't like in order to express and define the development of our literary taste. Have there been authors or themes or scenes who made you say, no, this fantasy doesn't work for me?
I don't think I'd pick out one author or one book that didn't work for me. I mean, I read a huge amount of fantasy as a kid, leading on from Tolkien, the commercial fantasy of the 80s and 90s, writers like David Eddings, Weiss and Hickman's Dragonlance, the sort of commercial core of the genre that was becoming very popular at that time. And it wasn't that there was something I disliked about them particularly. I love those books and thoroughly enjoy reading them. But I think I started to feel that around that time, the early 90s, the genre became a bit one-noted, a bit predictable, if you like, a bit safe. Going over the same ground a lot, so there was a lot of moral simplicity, there was a lot of very shiny heroism, and there was a bit of a lack of the kind of the grit, the danger, the edge that I would see in a lot of other styles of fiction that I was reading, so noir fiction, westerns, and more literary mainstream stuff. And I started to wonder why no one was writing a kind of character-focused style of book within the fantasy genre. And then in the mid-90s, of course, I read George R. R. Martin's Game of Thrones and saw a lot of what I thought had been missing from the genre really expressed in that book. And it proved to me you could write something that had all the virtues of epic fantasy, the scale and the magic and the drama, the action, but could also be very character-focused, very gritty, and feel very dangerous and unpredictable. And I think that was one big influence on me, one big reason why I felt, you know, I could have a go at doing something myself along similar lines.
How has your writing changed over time? Were there different challenges that fascinated you at first? Or are they always the same, perhaps with different nuances?
I don't think my writing has changed immensely over time. I mean, certainly I've got faster at achieving a reasonable result. There was a lot of trial and error to begin with. I had no kind of formal training in writing, so a lot of trial and error, a lot of revision, a lot of going over and over the same things to kind of try and develop my voice, to understand how to go about it, what elements of a scene to concentrate on. So I've got much quicker. I think as well, the fundamental approach of trying to really get into the head of vivid and interesting people and see what the world looks like from inside their heads, that's the same. That's really what I aim for. And from that, I think, flows those things like an involvement with the story, a sense of risk and danger in the action that I'm always looking for. When I first started writing, as I was saying earlier, it was partly a reaction against a lot of the fantasy that I'd read up to that point. Some of that safer, more heroic, more familiar fantasy. I wanted to do something with an edge that was unpredictable, that was morally ambiguous, that was character focused. And in doing that, I did something that was quite opposite to a lot of what I've read. I did something that was quite pessimistic, quite cynical, quite unheroic, quite gritty. And I've often tended to write things in that line, but I think there's a danger that you can become predictable for kind of overwhelming cynicism, just as you can become predictable for too much optimism. And I wouldn't want to do that. So I think over time I've perhaps become a little less cynical in some of my endings, a little less misanthropic, if you like. You want there to be a range in your books. You want there to be, you know, good things, bad things, and I'm a little more conscious of that, and I try and do something that, if possible, reflects real life as much as I can now.
Where is fantasy going for you today? Can you identify currents of common interest in terms of stylistic research, political themes, or do the richness and variety of approaches make any scheme useless and reductive?
Well, I mean, the past is pretty hard to understand and encompass, let alone to try and predict the future. It's always virtually impossible task. In a way, I kind of feel that this task of predicting the way the genre is going, and by extension of kind of categorising books into groups and looking at movements, it's something that's more for publishers and critics and, in a way, readers to do than it is for writers. I think there's a risk to writers of trying to somehow see what the trends are and try and write to them. I think the moment you stop writing the thing that you want to write and start thinking about what the market might want, you run the risk of doing something that nobody wants at all. It's always too late to catch a wave, and no one ever sees the really big, important, influential book that really changes things coming. But there's certainly been some noticeable changes in recent times. Urban fantasy has become a huge part of the marketplace. Within epic fantasy, which is obviously my corner, there's definitely been a kind of expansion of the range. Things were very heroic in commercial fantasy, very morally simple for a long time. These days, you know, gritty fantasy, grimdark as it's sometimes called, has become much more of a part of the landscape. Game of Thrones definitely ushered in a whole generation of new writers who are interested in pushing the envelope of kind of the darkness of the human condition, if you like, where instead of shiny heroes fighting dark lords, you have questions over who is the right side, who is the wrong side, is there any such thing as a hero or a villain, or are there just grey characters contending in a much muddier world? And I think perhaps that style of fiction seems to reflect the world as it is a little better now than it did perhaps in the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, during the time of the Cold War. We're used to a more morally relativistic world, if you like, where no one is totally sure of the right side. That's certainly reflected in fantasy.